Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Human Respiration. In that we are studying topic pharynx. When I say pharynx, this is the area which is just located below your nose or nostrils. Let's study a little bit more about pharynx today. Pharynx. This is the area which is just below your nasal cavity, or I can say just below your nostril or nose. It's a short vertical tube, I can say, through which air that is entering from the atmosphere by your lungs, which is your right and left nostril, passes through this pharynx region. Now, pharynx could be divided into two different regions. One is nasopharynx and another one is oropharynx. Now, nasopharynx is the part that actually conducts the air. When I say conducts the air, it is a mixture of all the gases in the atmosphere which you are inhaling. Whereas oropharynx is the pipe that actually carries the food. So, nasopharynx and oropharynx are just adjacent pipes. Oropharynx could also be said in a other term, esophagus, or a part of esophagus. And we all know that esophagus is associated with food pipe. Lastly, in pharynx, there are some tonsillar regions, and these tonsillar regions are made up of lymphatic tissues. Now, lymphatic tissues will obviously kill bacteria since they are associated with certain immune cells, and these immune cells could be your phagocytic cells. In pharynx, there is a structure named as Adam's apple also. Pharynx. When I talk about pharynx, it could be said as a passage which is just below your nostrils or nasal cavity. So whenever you inhale air or you inspire air, which is a mixture of gases, the first place it passes down is the hollow cavity of pharynx. So air travels from your nasal cavity to pharynx. It is a short vertical tube that consists of two regions. One is nasopharynx that conducts air, and another one is oropharynx that actually carry food to esophagus, or you can say the food pipe. In pharynx, there are tonsillar regions. The white secretions of tonsillar regions are, apart from being mucus, also lymphatic tissues. Now, these lymphatic tissues will contain macrophages, dendritic cells, all of them. Now, they are termed as phagocytic cells, or the cells that actually engulf or eat the harmful bacteria. Whenever you respire, if there is a harmful bacteria in the atmosphere and you have taken it, these macrophages, dendritic cells or lymphatic tissues will actually kill those bacteria. Now, once air leaves the pharynx, it means it has passed down the pharynx region. It reaches the larynx. Now, larynx is also termed as voice box. the voices which we have as males and females is due to the differences in larynx. For example, in males, the larynx produces hoarse voices or little bit deep voices, which eventually changes as you grow in age. And in females, the voices are little soft. Larynx is also termed as Adam's apple. Students, this is a diagram of pharynx. Now, as you can see that this is the location of your nostrils, which could be your right and left nostril. Now, once your intake of air is done, the air passes down to your nasopharynx, whereas the food that you chew with the help of your mouth goes down to oropharynx. Now, food from your oropharynx will eventually go down to tract, pass down to your stomach region, to your esophagus region. But once you inhale air through your nasopharynx, they pass down to your hypopharynx region, which, and then finally to your larynx, which is just below your hypopharynx or pharynx region, and finally to the trachea. Now, trachea is the windpipe in human individuals, and this windpipe contracts and relaxes eventually, and then finally the molecules of air would be passed down to your respiratory system. Also, there is a system, or you can say an organ, which is termed as epiglottis. Now, opening of a pharynx region into larynx is called as epiglottis. Yes, you heard me right. Opening of pharynx into larynx is called as epiglottis, and it is guarded by soft movable flip or flap, and that is the epiglottis or glottis region. Also, pharynx and larynx are co-connected with each other. There are chances whenever you get respiratory tract infection, your nostrils would not be affected that much. Obviously, you're inhaling air through them. But once that bacteria, now this bacteria could be anything. It could be your normal rhinovirus, the cough and cold bacteria. It could be the tuberculosis bacteria. It could be the multi-drug resistant TB bacteria, anything. Reaches your pharyngeal region or pharynx, then the bacteria tries to harbor in that region, or tries to grow, depending upon the severity or how dangerous that bacteria is. Yes, the pharynx cells or immune system will try to kill those bacteria, but this doesn't happen every time. Students, in this part of the chapter, we did study about pharynx, its location, its function, its association with respiratory tract. I hope we are very clear with this concept. Thank you.